Hello everyone, this is Lata Apala. In this video, we are going to study about meristematic tissue. So we have already taken some introduction about the meristematic tissue and permanent tissue, where the meristematic tissue consists of continuously dividing cells, right? Whereas the permanent tissue consists of the cells which have stopped their division, right? So we'll study about meristematic tissue and its classification and types of meristematic tissues. So these meristematic tissues that can be classified based on two reasons. One is based on where the based on origin in the life of the plant, and second reason is based on the position of the meristem. So by taking these two reasons, the meristematic tissues can be classified. The first reason is on the basis of origin in the life of the plant. So based on the origin in the life of the plant, when the meristematic tissue develops, whether it develops in the early stages of the life or the latter, based on this, we have two types of meristems. One is the primary meristem and second one is the secondary meristem. In the primary meristem, primary, that means it develops first, early in the life of the plant. This meristem, the primary meristem, develops at the early in the life of the plant, hence it is called as primary meristem. And this primary meristem is responsible for the development of primary plant body, such as roots, stems, leaves, branches, all are developed. The structure of the plant, first primary development of the plant is because of this primary meristems only, and the cells present in this primary meristem is always in actively growing stage. That means they are always dividing and increasing the plant body and develops the all the parts of the plant. And this primary meristems, after dividing for several stages, later the cells present in that primary meristem that converted into the primary permanent tissue. From the meristematic tissue only the permanent tissue develops, right? Here, from the primary meristems, what develops after several stages, that develops into primary permanent tissue. So the permanent tissue means there is no division. The cells present in that permanent tissue, they stop dividing. They lost the capability of dividing. And the second one is secondary meristem. The secondary meristem, that means after the primary meristem, it develops, hence it develops the latter stages of the life, not in the early stages. So after primary tissue develops, hence it is develops later, hence it is called as secondary tissue. That means if you take the newly developed plant, how it was, it has a tender leaves, very delicate stem, smooth roots, right? All are the primary parts. After several years, what happened to that plant? That plant will become very rough, woody and strong, right? That is because of the development of secondary tissue. This secondary meristem develops on the latter stages of that life, and that form the secondary tissues. Because of the formation of that secondary tissues only, the plant will become woody and strong. And the woody areas are because of the for production of the secondary tissues. They are not present at the beginning, they develop later. And this is about the classification of the meristems on the basis of origin. And the second classification is based on the position in the plant body, where in which place the meristematic tissue was developing. Based on that reason, we have three different types of meristems. One is apical meristem, intracalary meristem and lateral meristem. The apical meristem, if you see this, the name indicates apical tips. Apical means nothing but tips. So here, the meristems which develops at the shoot tips, root tips and branch tips, that is called as apical meristem. Again, this apical meristem is two types. Based on its position, if it develops at the root tips, it is called as a root apical meristem. If it develops at the stem tips, it is called as a shoot apical meristem. How many types? Root apical meristem one. If it develops at the root tips, it is called as root apical meristem. It develops at the stem tips, it is called as shoot apical meristems. And if you see the functions of this apical meristem is responsible for the formation of the primary tissues. These primary tissues forms the primary growth of the plant, right? Here, the apical meristem is reason for the development of the primary tissue, which lead to the development of the primary plant body. and the increase in the length of the plant is also the because of the presence of this apical meristem only. And when the apical meristem was increasing at the tip, it is dividing and dividing, the length of the root increases. If it dividing at the stem tips, the length of the stem will increases. That means the height, the length of the plant increases because of this apical meristem only. And the next one is the formation of axillary bud also the because of the apical meristem. What is the bud actually? The bud is nothing but underdeveloped shoot is called as bud. Here the axillary buds are formed because of the apical meristem. We see that if we take the shoot apical meristem, that shoot apical meristem with the help of that the stem was elongating in the lengthwise. While it was increasing its length, the leaves will develop from the sides, and while the stem was growing, the stem, some cells of this stem apical shoot apical meristem will be left behind. Those left behind cells, they form the axillary bud. So those left behind cells only form the axillary bud. What is the axillary bud? I have already explained in the previous videos. Axillary bud is nothing but the bud which is formed between the upper part of the stem and the stalk of the leaf. Between these two, the bud develops. So in between these two, some angle is created, right? Within that angle, that is called as axil. In that axil, the bud develops, so it is called as axillary bud. So after, from this axillary bud, later a branch will develop. Or it may develop a flower also. A flower. Later this axillary bud will develop into a branch or a flower. And next one is intercalary meristem. Intercalary meristem means here this intercalated, it is intercalated between two mature tissues. This is a mature tissue. Mature tissue is nothing but the permanent tissue. So between two permanent tissues or two mature tissues, this intercalary meristem develops. And this intercalary meristem, they also helps in the lengthwise increase in the plant also. And this apical meristem is the primary meristem. This intercalary meristem is also the primary meristem only. And that means it develops at the early stages of the life. And they also helps in the length of the plant. In the grass plants, if any herbivorous plants that feed on the grasses, some parts of the grass plants will be lost while grazing, and those lost parts of the grass plants will get regenerated by this intercalary meristem. They again, after several days, those last parts of the grass plants will again develop. That is because of the intercalary meristem only. And if we see in the cereal plants during heavy storms, they will fallen again. These fallen stems of the cereal plants, if they will get erected, they become erect because of this intercalary meristem. And these intercalary meristems, they also helps in the elongation of the organs of the plant. So this is about intercalary meristem. And the last one is the lateral meristem. The lateral meristem means indicates it is present at the lateral sides of the roots and stems. It is present at the lateral sides of the roots and stems, hence it is called as lateral meristem. And it was seen only in the mature regions of the roots and stems. They are not developed at the early stages of the plant. Only this lateral meristem develops at the mature regions of the stems and mature regions of the roots. Only this lateral meristem will develop. And these are present only, this lateral meristem was not present on all plants. Only in the plants which consists of the woody axis, in those plants only this lateral meristem develops. And this lateral meristem, it develops in the latter stages of the life, hence it is the secondary meristem. You need to remember, this apical meristem and intercalary meristems are the primary meristems, whereas this lateral meristem, it develops at the latter stages of the life, hence it is the secondary meristem. And here, in this lateral meristem, it consists of cylindrical meristems. What type of meristem it is? It is a cylindrical meristem. This lateral meristem, it divides in a radial direction. Radial direction means from the center to the periphery it was dividing, and it increases the girth of the plant. The girth of the plant is increased because of the development of this lateral meristem only. And here the secondary tissue like secondary xylem, secondary phloem, cork, cambium, all these formed because of this lateral meristems only. The secondary growth of the plant such as secondary xylem, secondary phloem and cork, cambium, which is a woody structure, protective tissue which is formed around the woody plants, that was developed because of this lateral meristems only. If you see the examples of this, but one is the fascicular vascular cambium or intrafascicular vascular cambium is also formed because of this lateral meristem. What is the fascicular intrafascicular vascular cambium? The meristematic tissue which is present inside the vascular tissue is called as fascicular vascular cambium. And second one is interfascicular vascular cambium. Interfascicular vascular cambium means the meristematic tissue which is present between vascular bundles, between the two bundles, if the vascular cambium was developed, the meristematic tissue was developed, that is called as interfascicular cambium. And next one is the last one is the cork cambium. This cork cambium is a tough protective material formed during the secondary growth. On the stem, the secondary growth will develop which protect the stem, that is called as cork cambium. So this secondary tissues are formed because of the lateral meristems only. This is about the different types of meristems based on their origin and their position. So with this we have completed the meristematic tissue. The next video we are going to study about the permanent tissue. If you like my video, please like, share and subscribe to my channel Lata Akula Biology Tutorial. Please keep watching.